Governor, speaking of that press conference, you also mentioned there that there was a high-level meeting yesterday, and succeedingly, Defense Secretary Gilbert Teodoro announced that the President has ordered the PCG to conduct an investigation into the incident. Is this a prelude to the filing of cases against China?
Well, I cannot share what happened yesterday in the command conference called by the President because of reasons of national security. And I think the decisions taken at that meeting will be announced at the proper time, no? Because China does not announce what they intend to do. So why should the Philippines also do the same? So I cannot share what was discussed. However, let me just state that the President and the entire cabinet, including National Security Advisor Eduardo Anyo, is taking this latest provocative act seriously, no? Because a collision has occurred between two ships, and clearly, as shown by videos and photos that we have released, and also by the report of ABS-CBN itself, no? Bianca Daba was there. The entire world now knows that the collision that happened in the West Philippine Sea was caused by the dangerous maneuvers of Chinese Coast Guard vessels acting in concert with the Chinese maritime militia.
Mm-hmm. And as we saw in the videos, China has become more audacious when it comes to impinging on our territory and our EEZ in the West Philippine Sea. How can the Philippines actually fortify its RORA missions, its rotation and resupply missions, considering, as mentioned, that China has become more adamant, more provocative in its actions in the West Philippine Sea?
Yes, that is correct. No, we see a increasing provocation on the part of China, which is why when we hear the Chinese spokesperson playing the blame on the Philippines, no, that we are the ones hyping and media hyping and creating these tensions, no, we do not know where that is coming from. No, for example, the statement coming from the Chinese Coast Guard that it was the BRP Cabra that allegedly moved to collide with the Chinese maritime militia was belied by the report of Bianca Daba of ABS-CBN, who was there out on the scene and saw that the Philippine Coast Guard captain of BRP Cabra stopped its engine to prevent the collision. But the Chinese maritime militia continued to move, causing the collision. So the false narratives coming from Beijing is the one creating these tensions and the movements of the Chinese Coast Guard and Chinese maritime militia in the West Philippine Sea during our RORA missions are the ones increasing tensions, and definitely not the Philippines.
Yes. Before we go to that point, let me just go back to the question to get a clearer answer. How can the Philippines actually fortify its RORA missions now that China is behaving this way? How can we actually make sure that this won't happen again anytime soon?
You know, Katrina, we have to take a long view of this, no? Because China takes the long view as well. So we take the long view, should also take the long view. And as to what we will do to fortify our position, that is for the cabinet to decide. That is for the president to decide. And we are waiting for further instructions from Malacañan. Right now, what we have is the directive of the president to conduct a maritime investigation. And the Philippine Coast Guard commandant has already committed to release that report, to submit that report to the president in 5 days. Mm-hmm. So I would surmise that in 5 days' time, the cabinet cluster on security with the president will meet again to decide on future steps to be undertaken, which unfortunately I cannot share right now for reasons of national security.
I understand that operational details must not be disclosed, but I just have to try. How close is the Philippines to asking the U.S. and its other allies to join RORA missions?
Again, much as I would like to answer, no, I cannot do so because we never hear China explaining to the media what they intend to do. And so the Philippines should also not do the same, because it would not be good if we are telegraphing our punches to China, because then China might prepare its responses and render inutile whatever approach that we intend to take.
I understand. Just trying to shoot my shot there. Anyway, Assistant Director General, you were saying earlier you were questioning the narrative of China. Would it be fair to say that this is a clear case of gaslighting coming from Asia's largest economy?
Yes, definitely there is what is called as a malign information operation going on. There's a false narrative that is being shared to the public, and we are just so happy that it is not just the Philippine government that is sharing our side here. We have allies, if we may call them, witnesses from the media who were there on the spot, no? Who had access to the deck and who had access to the control center of the Philippine Coast Guard vessels, who listened to the radio challenges, who saw what was exactly happening, who were witnesses themselves to the overwhelming number of Chinese vessels acting in concert, and how Unai Sa May 2 was corralled and was bumped, no? By a Chinese Coast Guard, a large, no, Chinese Coast Guard vessel. So all of these false narratives are coming from the People's Republic of China. And unfortunately, some of our countrymen are falling into this trap. So definitely, Katrina, we need to be discerning, and we need to make the proper understanding and appreciation of the facts. We must see the facts for themselves and not be swayed by the false narrative coming from Beijing.
Mm-hmm. And you mentioned that China is taking this at a lot, is preparing for a long view in this. Now, aside from the incident on Sunday morning, what else is China doing in the West Philippine Sea? What other activities has the NSC monitored so far, aside from Chinese ships shadowing our own vessels in our own EEZ?
Well, there's a lot of movement going on. We are, again, monitoring a large number of Chinese maritime militia vessels, not only in the vicinity of Ayungin Shoal or in the vicinity of Baho de Masinloc, but also in other features, like Sabina Shoal, no, for example. And we are, of course, alarmed by the environmental degradation that our Coast Guard ships were able to monitor in these areas, no, because the environmental degradation or the coral destruction impacts directly on the livelihood of our fishermen. You know, Katrina, sometimes we forget the reason why we are pushing for our rights in the West Philippine Sea. No, some critics are saying that this is just posturing on the part of the Philippines, or a tug of war for power between the Philippines and China. No, this is not. No, this is a battle for the resources of our country, particularly those of our fishermen. So when we monitor coral destruction in other parts of the West Philippine Sea, it alarms the Philippine government, because it directly impacts the livelihood of our fishermen in the West Philippine Sea, upon which their livelihood relies.
And the worry right now, Assistant Director General, is the capability of the Philippines in stopping China, not only when it comes to possible collisions and dangerous maneuvers in the West Philippine Sea, but more importantly, as you mentioned, in the destruction of the maritime biodiversity in the country. What is the government actually doing to somehow change the status quo?
Well, our intent is for the future, no, that in the future, the Philippines, the situation becomes in favor of the Philippines, no? Meaning that we are able to assert our rights over the West Philippine Sea as granted to us by the 2016 arbitral ruling and by relevant laws and regulations, no? So we intend, and as not really intend, we are doing right now more maritime patrols and freedom of navigation missions across the West Philippine Sea based on our limited capacity. So it is, we appreciate, no? We appreciate very much the commitment coming from Congress for the support for Horizon 3, which is the third phase of the modernization program of the Armed Forces of the Philippines, which will mean more resources for us to purchase ships and fighter aircraft for our armed forces, and the additional support that was promised to us also by Congress in the next year's General Appropriations Act for the Philippine Coast Guard modernization and for the Philippine Coast Guard to purchase more ships. No, the president during his last visit to the Philippine Coast Guard promised the purchase of additional vessels for the PCG. So that is a good development that would allow the Philippines to assert more its position in that part of the world.
And finally, ADG, before we let you go, are there any plans, or is it already in the works? Somehow, is the Philippines and China arranging a high-level or even a top-level bilateral talk to somehow ease tensions in the area? Is the president of the two, are the presidents of the two countries somehow trying to sort it out between themselves, considering that they met personally in January 2023, a hotline was established?
You know, Katrina, I really don't know if there are plans for a state visit, if there are plans for a discussion between the two heads of state. But to answer your question, there are bilateral mechanisms for the Philippines and China to meet regularly. There's the bilateral consultation mechanism. There are many high-level interactions between Philippine diplomats and Chinese diplomats. In fact, right now, there is a ongoing discussion on the code of conduct, on the proposed code of conduct on the West Philippine Sea happening right now, hosted by China in Beijing. So there are discussions taking place. However, since China does not want to budge on its position that the entire South China Sea is theirs, no, the discussion is like talking to one, talking past one another, no. It is not a real discussion, but merely a reiteration of positions that have hardened already. No, that is why our appeal to the People's Republic of China is for them to act responsibly, no, respect international law, and adhere to the rule of law. No, because they themselves also are signatories to UNCLOS, and because they are signatories to UNCLOS, the decision of the 2016 arbitral tribunal is effective both for the Philippines and China.
And we will have to wait and see what comes out of that meeting with regard to the negotiations for the DOC. Thank you so much for joining us this morning, NSC Assistant Director General Jonathan Malaya.
Thank you.